learn the new chapter 10, circles. You have studied in 9th class that the circle is the collection of all the points which are at a constant distance from a fixed point. That constant distance is called the radius and the fixed point is called center of a circle. And double of the radius will be diameter. Let us draw the circle and the line. There are the three possibilities to draw it. Let us see one by one. In the first figure, there is no common point of the line PQ and the circle. So in this case, the line PQ is called non-intersecting line with respect to circle. In the second case, there are the two common points A and B of a line PQ and the circle. Then, in this equation, the line PQ is called the second of a circle. In the third case, there is only one common point of a line PQ and the circle. So, this PQ is called the tangent to the circle. So, only one tangent can be drawn at every point of a circle. Let us see this with an activity. See, this is the tangent PQ. This is an tangent PQ which is passing through A. Suppose A is fixed through A only. One point will be A only. It will rotate this way. In this way. So you will get to know that A is fixed, but another point also you are getting common point. So this, if there are the two common points, which means it will be second. So it will become, it will not be now tangent, it will be second. If you will rotate in this way, then also A is fixed, but another point also you are getting, which means it will be also second. Which means it proves that only one tangent can be drawn at every point of a circle. At every point of a circle. Which means it indicates that the tangent of a circle, tangent to the circle, is a special case of a PQ, special case of a secant, where the end point of its corresponding chord, will coincide. Means, suppose this is the PQ is the second, and the corresponding chord will be AB. So the end point of the corresponding chord AB will coincide. They both will be at one point. Then this line will become a tangent. The line will become a tangent. So, let's see the theorem. Let us see this theorem. The tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. So, this we will see through the diagram. Here it is given that the circle, we are given a circle with center O and tangent XY to the circle at a point P, and we need to prove that OP is perpendicular to XY. OP is perpendicular to XY. Let us take a point, another point Q, which is other than P and which will be outside of the circle. If the point Q lies inside of the circle, which means it will become a second, that XY will become a second. So, that point Q should lie on XY. We took the point Q which is lying on XY and which will be outside of the circle. So, if we will see this distance OP, it will be smaller than OQ. OP is smaller than OQ. So, it will, which means OQ will be longer than OP. OP is smaller than OQ. Which means OQ is a longer than OP. So if we will take another point Q1, then if you draw this line, if you join this, then also OP will be smaller than OQ. If it will take the another point Q2, then also it will happen the same. OP will be smaller than OQ. If it will take another point, then also you will get that OP will be smaller than. If you take this side also, then also OP will be, this will be right angle triangles, all the right angle triangles will get with the OP, and you will get to know that this OP will be smaller than the other lines, other distances. OP distance, the distance OP from center O will be smaller than the other distances. Smallest OP is the smallest.